Hi, I'm Oscar van Deventer, and these are the Ambigu gears from Ambigears and Gearing. So the Ambigu gears starts with gear theory. What you know about gears is when you have a gear train that is multiple gears in a row, and the first gear and the last gear have the same number of teeth, then they should turn at the same speed. So here we have a gear with 10 teeth, and here we have another gear with 10 teeth. And independent of the number of teeth in the middle, they should speed the same, because if it's 10 to 9 to 10, or 10 to 8 to 10, or 10 to 10 to 10, in all cases, the outer ones should turn at the same speed. Obviously, this will not be the case for this one. You probably have seen my videos before. So when I'm turning this gearing set, what you see is that even gear 1 and 2, they are turning at the same speed, but gear number 3 is turning more slowly. And the two gears get out of alignment. So what's happening here? Well, what you see here are helical gears. So here number 1 is a right-handed a helical gear with 10 teeth, and number 3 is a left-handed one. But the one in the middle is the Boolean intersection of a right-handed gear with 9 teeth and a left-handed gear with 10 teeth. So that's why you get these dots here. So one of the sides of the dots interacts with one gear and the other with the other. So for this gearing system, it's actually 10 to 10. 9 to 10. So effectively it's 9 to 10, which explains why the 3 gear is turning more slowly. So here we have a gear train that doesn't satisfy gear train theory, that the outer gears, when they have the same size, they should spin at the same speed. Well, this is a nice proof of concept, and you see that it works. But is there any practical application? So that's my question to you, the practical application of this funny gear train. Thank you for watching.